Hello, grade 11s. Welcome to Edu-ca-te. Today we'll be discussing the nephron and excretion in humans. Just to recap, in our previous two videos, we have said that the kidney is able to filter or clean blood, that is waste products. These waste products are excreted as urine. So blood that has got waste has to enter into the renal artery, and the waste is filtered in the kidney. Then the clean blood leaves the kidney through the renal vein. So if you do not understand any of those above 2 points, I recommend that you watch our previous two videos that explain that blood is filtered through the kidney. So now we zoom into the kidney to see the functional unit of the kidney, which we call the nephron. So the nephron is a very small thing. So it's sort of like a small part that is found inside the kidney. So specifically in the kidney, the nephron is found in the renal pyramid. So if I'm just going to point to you what the renal pyramid is this part here. The renal pyramid is this pyramid-like structure that looks something like this. So as this structure is found inside the kidney, it contains a certain part which we call the nephron. So remember when you said that the kidney has to filter the blood that has got waste products, the actual part that filters the blood in the kidney is called the nephron. That is the one that does all the functions. That's why we say it is the functional unit of a kidney. So nephrons are microscopic. So they are very small, extremely small, and they're just found as millions and millions inside this kidney, specifically at the renal pyramid. So remember, I've said that the renal artery is the one that is bringing the blood with waste products. So as the renal artery gets into the kidney, it branches out into smaller blood vessel. So you can see that the renal artery is only one artery, but then when it gets inside the kidney, it becomes many blood vessels. It branches out into many blood vessels, and each of those blood vessels will go to different nephrons, so that the blood can be cleaned. Remember that the blood in the renal artery has got waste products and it is oxygenated. So those waste products, for them to be cleaned, they have to go all the way to this pyramid so that they can get inside the nephron. So one more thing I would like to highlight here on the structure of the kidney is the pyramid, that it has got a medulla as well as a cortex. So specifically in this diagram which I have drawn of the renal pyramid, the top part of the renal pyramid, we call it the renal cortex. So this is known as the renal cortex, whereas the bottom part is known as the renal medulla. So remember always to say renal, because that indicates that it is something related to the kidney. So in this case, there is a renal cortex as well as the renal medulla. So now, the nephron, this is how it looks like. This is the diagram that shows how a nephron looks like. It is a coiled structure, and there are many of them, as I have already indicated, that there are millions of nephrons in the kidney, and they are the ones that actually filter the blood. So, first of all, we need to know that the nephron can be divided into two main parts, the Malpighian body as well as the renal tubule. So the Malpighian body is the top part of the nephron. Specifically, it is this part I am circling with the red. This is called the Malpighian body. Whereas the remaining part, or the bottom part here, which I'll be still circling with blue, this part is known as the renal tubule. So we can just say that the nephron is divided into distinct parts, which are the Malpighian body, which is the top part, as well as the renal tubule, which is the bottom part. So now, the thing is, the Malpighian body, this top part, it is found in the renal cortex. So remember that in the previous diagram, I've said that this is the cortex region. This all is a pyramid, right? Is the renal pyramid. It is this part here. It is the renal pyramid. But specifically inside the renal pyramid, the Malpighian body will be found in the cortex. This part which I've circled with red, this part which I've circled with red, this one will be found in the renal cortex. It will be found in the top part of the pyramid. Whereas the remaining part, which is the renal tubule, this one which I have circled with blue, will be found in the renal medulla. It will be found here, just to specify. So in this video, we're only going to be looking at the Malpighian body, because the Malpighian, because if we were to look at the renal tubule, it would take millions of years. So I will make another video that will actually explain what happens at the renal medulla. So at the renal cortex, we have said that we find the Malpighian body. This is how it looks like. Remember the Malpighian body, it is what I've circled with red. It has got all these parts. All these parts, the afferent arteriole, the glomerulus, as well as the Bowman's capsule. So this is just a zoom in of it. So this part called the afferent arteriole, you can also see it from this whole diagram. This is known as the afferent arteriole. So when you say you've got an artery, when that artery branches out into smaller parts, we say it is an arteriole. So remember, we've said that as the renal artery enters the kidney, it branches out into small blood vessels. So since this renal artery is an artery, then it is going to branch out into smaller parts called the arterioles. So this one is known as the afferent arteriole. So it means that it is branching out from the renal artery. So bear in mind that the renal artery brings in blood with waste products, and that blood is oxygenated. So the afferent arteriole, we have said that it branches from the renal artery and it comes in with blood that is containing waste. Remember, the main function of the kidney is to clean that waste from the blood, right? We say it's a nitrogenous waste. All that nitrogenous waste has to be cleaned from the blood so that the blood can go back and work in the body while it's clean. So those waste products, remember that they have to be cleaned and they will be released as urine. So the afferent arteriole will bring that blood that has got waste products into the nephron. So this is the blood. It moves into this whole part. So this whole part that looks like a cup, we say it is known as the Bowman's capsule. So the Bowman's capsule is actually this thing, this whole thing that looks like a cup, this cup-shaped structure, something like this. I'm sure you can even see it from this diagram. This is the Bowman's capsule. So the Bowman's capsule, it is just this this cup-like structure, and inside it we find the glomerulus. So the glomerulus, if I have to point it out here, the glomerulus, it is this part. This is known as the glomerulus. So this part is sort of like a coiled structure, sort of like looks like a snake. So this is known as the glomerulus. So the blood that has got waste products, we have said that it enters the afferent arteriole. And then when it enters the afferent arteriole, it will go into this part called the glomerulus. So when it goes into this part called the glomerulus, what will happen? The blood will be filtered. Remember, the whole purpose is for the blood to not have waste. So as this blood enters with a lot of waste product, when it reaches the glomerulus, the waste will just diffuse from the blood, and it will go into this part called the proximal convoluted tubule. So the waste that comes out from the blood in the glomerulus, it goes into this part known as the proximal convoluted tubule. So the waste actually leaves through slits, which are small pores. So when we're talking about slits, we're talking about small holes, just small holes here at the Bowman's capsule here. So if we've got small holes here, when the blood reaches at this point, filtration will happen. So it means that the waste products will move from this blood in the glomerulus, and then they will move all the way into the what? All the way into the proximal convoluted tubule. So they will move through these holes, we call them slits. So now when this blood is filtered, it will leave, and then it will leave through the efferent arteriole and go to the other parts. So the efferent arteriole actually carries the blood that has been filtered, meaning that the blood is clean because it does not have any waste products anymore, because the waste products have already diffused from the blood at the glomerulus, right? So now this filtered blood will move out of this this whole Malpighian body through the efferent arteriole. So the efferent arteriole carries filtered blood. So that's just the tip of an iceberg. In the next video, we'll be talking about this whole thing, this whole process called the glomerular filtration. So this video was just to give an idea that the filtration actually happens here at the glomerulus. So this process whereby the blood is filtered at the glomerulus, it is known as the glomerular filtration. So in our next video, we're going to be looking at step by step at how that happens. I hope this has given you understanding, and thank you for watching.